Hi, this is Robert, and I'm going to be doing exercise number one for chapter two. It's on page 14 of the SPSS Basics second edition, so you're welcome to come join me on this. For question number one, it says you'll be entering the scores shown in table 2.2 below for attitude towards math into SPSS. And so hopefully you're following along with your own book. And so specifically do the following. And A was to start SPSS, and you can see that's done here. B was indicate that you want to type in data, and that's done. In other words, it's opened up a new SPSS sheet for me to fill out. C says click on the variable view tab. Okay, so we can go data view or variable view, and we're now on the variable view tab. D says name the variable, give it the name math. So I've gone ahead and given it the name math right here. Next, I'm asked in the label cell to go ahead and give it the name attitude towards math. And you can see that you can include spaces for label, but for the name, by the way, no spaces are permitted. By the way, I can kind of move these columns around if I want and make this bigger. There we go. All right, moving onward. Step F asks us to switch from the variable view to the data view. Okay, so this variable math is going to represent people's attitude towards math. It's a variable because for each person it can vary. It doesn't have to be the same thing. So we'll have it for person one, person two, person three, person four. What is their attitude towards math? And that's going to be entered into this column, and these will all be associated with that variable called math, or attitude towards math. So I'm typing these values in, and you can see I'm quite a fast typist because they're all entered now. Okay, next I'm asked to check the entry to make sure that I did all my data entry correctly. So I go through and just make sure that yes, I put in all the data right. If I don't put the data in right, then my answers will be incorrect at the end. So this is a really, really good step to check accuracy. Step I asks that I go ahead and save this data set, giving it the name attitude towards math. So to do that, I'm going to go to File, and I'll choose Save. I'm going to go ahead and save this file into My Documents, but you can choose a different location if you want to save your file. Okay, and I've given it the file name attitude towards math. So now I simply click Save, and we're done. This is the output saying that it has saved the file, and I'm good to go. All right, you've completed exercise one for chapter two.